Yep, here we go. This is where I usually set up. And I see the little cattle pond down here. And I see the Atlantic Ocean. And then I try to pick what I'm going to focus on. On the land, the ocean, or the sky.
When I'm painting paintings of people, like the people who are in this photo, right now I'm going to try and concentrate on the mid-tone areas. You can see that I've painted a lot of them already. I want to capture the blue shirt of the lady back here, and then I'm going to move to the man shirt, and then eventually I'm going to go all the way to the darks. And it's going to be, in this particular painting, it's definitely going to be the darks that make or break this piece.
I'm going to go with some very dark, blackish brown almost at the top of that inside edge. I'm going to add some rust color along the top of the bowl in a broken line.
One of the people who really inspires me is a Maine naturalist named Lee McMillan Hayes. Lee posted a photograph which absolutely knocked my socks off of a vernal pool. And I'll show you how I move from the photo to a painting. And what I was trying to capture was the sense of the rain, the patterns on the water, the layers below, or even something called fairy shrimp. I was just enchanted.
I've done these trees several times, and I'm trying to be very minimalistic because I don't want to attract a lot of attention to the trees, but I need to put some definition in here because otherwise I can't justify this reflection, which is really where I was, what I was after.
Some people think you can't correct watercolors and it is less forgiving, but you can go back. I mean, this paint is an example of a painting I did a few weeks ago, but I'm going back into it after I've been thinking about it and trying to think about the best way to improve it. So there we go.
I'm just about finished with this, and I've been working on it for a few days now, and I'm trying to build up layers to give it depth. And I'm very grateful to the Watercolor Society for keeping us engaged all this time during COVID. It's just been a wonderful thing to connect with other watercolorists and share our work.
So today I'm going to talk about painting in series as a different kind of process of creating art. So normally I think when you think about painting in series.
I will make a little shadow here. I need to make shadow in hand for finish. And I use full-time sketchbook, full-time. For every place that I go, I am drawing. These people that I saw in street, in bar, restaurant. This is, I saw people in the street and drawing.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yay!
Yay. Yay. Yay.